JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for February the 2nd. I am Charalambos, Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against all the other G10 currencies on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It gained the most versus SEK, CHF, CAD and the euro in that order, while it decked out the least gains against NOK and the Kiwi. The strengthening of the US dollar and the weakening of the loonie suggests that markets traded in a risk-off fashion yesterday and today in Asia. However, the weakening of the safe haven Swiss franc points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU and US indices were a sea of green with the positive investor morale rolling into the Asian session today. Equities bounced from their worst weekly decline since October, helped by a rise in mining shares after organized retail traders bought silver following thousands of Reddit posts and hundreds of YouTube videos, a similar phenomenon to the one which has driven a 1,600% rally in the shares of GameStop. Gains in technology stocks may have also fueled the improvement in the broader risk appetite. As for our view, although we may see more volatile swings due to coordinated buying of different assets by retail investors, we stick to our guns that as soon as the phenomenon dissipates, equities are likely to sail north and safe havens south. We believe that the rollout of the coronavirus vaccinations, although at a slower pace than previously expected, the extra loose monetary policy around the globe, and a large fiscal spending package in the US are a blend of developments which could keep the overall investor morale supported. Now back to the currencies. The euro was among the main losers, perhaps due to Germany's retail sales plunging by more than expected in December, while the Aussie slid somewhat overnight after the RBA decided to expand its QE program to buy an additional 100 billion Aussies of bonds. Officials also noted that the Aussie has appreciated and is now near the upper end of the range of recent years, which may be another driver behind the currency's overnight slide. The decision for expanding quantitative easing may have come as a surprise to many, including us, who have expected the bank to hold off from acting. Even the most pessimistic participants have been anticipating such an announcement to be made at the next gathering. In any case, with the decision now behind us and the bank reiterating the view that the economic recovery is well underway and that it has been stronger than earlier expected, we see the case for the Aussie to rebound at some point soon and trade higher. We believe that the main driver of this risk-linked currency is likely to continue being the broader risk appetite, despite some jawboning by the RBA. As we already noted, we expect investors' morale to continue improving, something that is likely to keep the Aussie supported. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the European session, we get Eurozone's first estimate of GDP for the fourth quarter, which is expected to have contracted 1.8% quarter over quarter after a rebounding 12.7% in the third quarter. This is likely to raise concerns with regards to the bloc's economic activity, especially taking into account the slowdown in the rolling of the coronavirus vaccinations. But we believe that Euro traders are likely to treat this release as outdated, given that we already have data showing how the Euro area economy has entered the new year, the likes of the PMIs. With a composite PMI staying in contractionary territory, the ECB is likely to remain ready to act again if the situation worsens. But with Lagarde saying that the downside risks are now less pronounced, and with inflation expected to have rebounded in January, we don't see the case for the ECB easing further its policy at its next policy meeting. Later in the day, we get the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week, but as it is always the case, no forecast is available. Tonight, during the Asia Morning Wednesday, New Zealand's employment report for the fourth quarter is coming out, and the forecast points to an increasing unemployment rate to 5.6% from 5.3%, while the employment change is expected to show that the economy has lost 0.8% quarter-over-quarter jobs, the same pace of decline as in the third quarter. Back in November, the RBNZ decided to keep its official cash rate and its large-scale asset purchase program unchanged, with Governor Andrian Orr saying that domestic activity since August has been more resilient than previously assumed. Quarter 4 inflation stayed unchanged at 1.4% year-over-year, within the bank's target range of 1-3%, keeping the probability of negative interest rates at very low levels. Although a weak employment report could raise some concerns and thereby hurt the QE, we doubt that it could drastically alter expectations around the RBNZ's monetary policy plans. In order for the RBNZ to start considering negative interest rates again, we believe that we need to see more data disappointing. As for the speakers, we have two on today's agenda, and those are New York Fed President John Williams and Cleveland Fed President Loretta Mester. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.